Let me know if this story sounds familiar. You work out 3 to 6 days a week, eat tons of food, drink water constantly, and get good sleep. But still, you aren't gaining muscle. If this story does sound familiar, then you probably know how frustrating it can be. You might even feel like your potential is capped and that you've met your limit. Sadly, I know a lot about that story. I was trying everything I could do that would possibly help me gain muscle, but still, no results came. I was as skinny and as weak as ever. So I asked myself, why does it seem impossible for me to get stronger, while for everyone else it seems so easy? Am I just born with bad genes that limit my potential? Should I just quit and end this madness? No, I couldn't let it end just like that. So instead, I learned how our bodies have evolved for millions of years, what exercises provide for the most strength gain, and how we can naturally boost human growth hormone and testosterone so that we become more powerful every day. It all comes down to evolution and biology. That's why in the new era of health, we've learned what makes your body tick a certain way. What signals you can send to your body that change your DNA, genes, and cells so that you burn fat effortlessly while also putting on the most defined muscle possible. What I learned annihilated every wall in my life that has kept me tamed, and it can do the same for you. But in order to break your plateau and to see rapid strength and size gains, you first need to understand what is happening to your body when you lift weights. You're applying stress to your body, and your body is going to adapt to that stress and get stronger and bigger muscles so that next time it can handle the stress you're applying to it. The reason why this happens, it comes down to evolution. Our bodies adapt in order to survive. And we see plenty of examples of this. That's what's happening when you tan. Your skin's adapting from the stress of the sunlight and getting darker so that the next time the sunlight won't damage or hurt it as much. And we also see it in the form of calluses. You could get sandpaper and rub it on your hand. And what's gonna happen after 2 to 3 days? Your body's gonna adapt to that stress and come back tougher and stronger in the form of a callus, so that next time it won't be damaged as much. So with that being said, if you aren't gaining muscle, the first possible factor could be that you're not increasing the intensity of your workout. If you don't increase the intensity of your workout, then your body has already handled the stress you're applying to it, so it doesn't need to grow in order to survive. Now, there's a few things you could do to increase the intensity of your workout. The first is increase the weight you are doing. The second would be decrease the rest time. And lastly, you could add more exercises to your workout. Now, the second possible factor that you're not gaining is that you're not eating enough calories. This is a pretty easy fix. All you need to do is consume about 400 to 500 calories on lifting days. If you eat empty calories like pizza, you're gonna get more fat. And if you eat nutrient-dense foods like veggies, eggs, nuts, or meats, you'll get more definition and toned muscles. Now, the third thing that could be causing you to plateau is you're overtraining or not sleeping enough. In either of these cases, you're not allowing your body to adapt to the stress you're applying to it. You see, when you lift weights, you're actually breaking down the muscle. And when you sleep or rest, your body is first gonna recover from the damage you applied. But after it recovers, it's gonna go into this adapting phase, which is when you see the gains. But the mistake most people make, that you might be making too, is that they train 5 to 7 days a week and they never really allow their bodies to adapt from the stress they're applying. Their bodies are just constantly in a state of recover, 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 instead of adapting. That's why in the new era of health, we work out 2 to 3 times a week to maximize muscular and neuro recovery so that you see the fastest strength gains with minimal effort. That's also why on our non-lifting days, we do other workouts like sprints to naturally boost human growth hormone and testosterone so that every time you walk into the gym, you're stronger, your lifts improve, and you get a dense, muscular, and proportional body. The future of training and health is here. We've entered into the new era of health, where we use our understanding of biology and evolution to change yourself on a cellular level so that you never plateau. You get a Greek god body like Zac Efron's, and you feel even better than you look. The time for you to become your true self is here. Download the new era of health handbook and unlock your full potential. Inside this handbook, you'll see that it's broken down into 3 sections. Or the 3 foundations of the new era of health, which are physical health, eating clean, and living a fulfilling and happy life. If you just want to increase your strength and size, follow the guidelines for the physical health. But if you want to do that while absolutely shredding fat, increasing your energy, mental clarity, and feeling superhuman, then follow the physical health and eating clean guidelines, and it will just be a matter of time before you get a Greek god body. Now, if you want to completely transform your life so that you look like a god, feel like one and accomplish even more than one, then fix all three foundations of the new era of health and do the total body transformation. Leave a comment and let me know if you're gonna ditch that old style training and jump into the new era of health so that you can have a Greek god body. If you like this video, make sure to toss it a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button so you can stay up to date with all my future content, and I'll see you in the next video.